Hello everyone, and welcome to another Heffy Doodle card video. I have the Unbearable Without You stamp set. At this point in the video, I have no idea what I'm doing, so I'm just kind of going with the flow. But I did make this other kind of Winnie the Pooh inspired card. This one's on my blog if you're interested in more information about that. I am cutting a stitched rectangle die. That's going to be my front card panel. This is Lawn Fawn wood grain cardstock. This is like the medium brown shade. It comes in several shades. And I'm trying to decide what color I want my front door. So I'm sorting through my mauvey pinks to decide what color I want to use. These are job ticket holders. A lot of people ask me about these. Many YouTube card makers use these to store their cardstock. You just chop off the top of these job ticket holders. It's not very much. And then your cardstock fits really nicely in there and it protects it and keeps it nice for when you want to use it. So I finally decided on using Paper Tray Inc.'s Amber Rose colored cardstock for my front door and my doorknob. That is a Your Next Stamp wood door die. And I'm using the Unbearable Without You stamp set to stamp my bear image. I'm going to make him look like Winnie the Pooh. So I originally wanted to make this card say, I love you this much, because I always squeeze my fingers together and tell Dexter that I love you everything except this much, and he never understands. He always moves his arms out wide and says, but mommy, I love you this much. That's more. One day he will be an adult and think, wow, my mom really did love me a whole lot. I'm stamping in Memento Tuxedo Black because I want to use my Copic markers to color my images. So now I'm taking my Memento ink marker. So it's not an ink pad, but it's the ink marker, because I'm going to do some selective inking here. I have my Honey Pot from the Unbearable Without You stamp set by Heffy Doodle, and I'm inking just the lines that I want. I don't want the lid, okay, because I'm going to create a stack of Honey Pots. So I'm just inking the rim of the Honey Pot and the bottom of the Honey Pot, and I'm using my marker to do this selectively. So now I'm going to whip out my beautiful blue Heffy Doodle masking paper tape and put some down right where my image was stamped in the Misty, just so I can stamp it again. And then I'm going to fussy cut the bottom of that bowl out so that I can have a mask for my bowl. And this is how I'm going to create the stack. So this bowl is the bottom bowl, and the bowl that I want to be first in line when you see it. So it needs to be the foremost image in your stack. Therefore, it needs the mask. So I'm being really super confusing and stacking this Honey Pot on top of the other one, trying to line it up so that it looks like it's, you know, stacked on top. And I'm also using my Memento Tuxedo Black marker to only ink the bottom of the pot again, because I'm going to create a stack of three. Now, sometimes I make a mess and I ink where I don't want to. So I have these micro brushes that I get from Amazon, and I kind of use the tip of that brush to clean up my lines where I'm a little sloppy, and it helps me create the look that I'm going for. So now I'm peeling off the mask and it really looks like they're stacked. So yay me. All right. So now I want to do one more on top. And this time I do want to add the lid. So I just ink the whole thing with my marker and stamp it down. This one was kind of a little off, but you know what? It's okay. Y'all get what I was going for. I've got a Copic multi-liner. We're going to do some enhancements to my images here. I'm creating a label on this pot that's going to be a label that says honey, and then I'm creating some drips on the other pots so that like honey is dripping out of the pot. At least that's what I'm going for. I hope that's what it looks like in the end. Do you guys ever put something away and then you can't find it? Yeah, that happens to me a lot. I couldn't find my little pencil eraser because I just want to erase some of the lines. I'm going to make them permanent with this Copic multi-liner. This is like a 0.03 tip. It's super, super fine. And I'm just writing, I've sketched it first, so it's not like I'm going right in. I'm not that brave, folks. But it says honey written in somewhat dyslexic fashion, and a shirt. I'm putting a shirt on my Pooh Bear because he does wear a shirt. I'm going to show you some of the Copic coloring. If you don't enjoy watching this, skip ahead to 6 minutes and 30 seconds, and you don't have to watch it. But here I also have a Copic color map if you'd like to just know what markers I'm using over on my blog at corinwiskman.com. I'm coloring as close, these are the colors that I feel are the closest to Pooh Bear colors. So it's in the YR family. And then I give him the symbolic red shirt that he wears. And I did have to do some tip to tip because I don't have all the markers or the markers are really far apart and I needed some help, some blending help. So, but Tim actually noticed that I was doing this, so I got to explain like the tip to tip thing to Tim. But you take the lighter marker and then you borrow some ink from the darker marker to make a medium shade. So when you feel like your two shades are too far apart, or if you don't have a marker or you need some extra blending help, this is a great way to create that third shade and stretch your markers. So instead of using three different markers, you just use two. But I used like 900 on this bear, so don't get me wrong, there's a long list of all of the markers that I used. I do also show on that list the honey pots, but I don't have that here. I cut them out with the either coordinating dies or I fuzzy cut them. Yep, I'm getting better at fuzzy cutting. I'm not great still. I'm terrible. I really struggled on what to do next. Okay, so I thought it was a slam dunk that I had the cute cool door and the pots, and then I was like, what am I gonna do with this sentiment? Because I really wanted it to say this much, but I just couldn't do it, so I had to wing it. And it says, I miss you so much. Somebody out there, someone, I need a this. And I need it to coordinate with everything. But anyway, I'm taking one of the stitched strips of ease and some of the sentiments from the Unbearable Without You stamp set, and I'm stamping them on Paper Tray Inc.'s Spring Rain light blue colored cardstock. It coordinates well with the crockery colors I used to color the pots. And I stamped it in Distress Oxide Seedless Preserves. So I don't, that's like, I don't hardly ever use it, and I've used it twice in the like last month. I'm taking some scrapbook.com double-sided adhesive, some white craft foam to pop up that wood grain piece. I also cut a grass tufts border, that one's a Your Next stamp die, out of vellum, green vellum. This is Anita's like pastel vellum pack. I love it. It's great. So I cut a little bit of grass from it. So I'm taking a C0, this is like a cool gray zero marker, and I'm going over the lines that were embossed by the die just to kind of enhance them a little so that they pop out a little bit more. And then I'm using glue dots to pop up my handle, and then Scotch 3M foam tape to pop up both the sentiment and the grass. So it's kind of like triple foam tape here, but I think it looks really cool. So I'm putting that below the door, and then I'm using more Scotch 3M foam tape to adhere to both my pots and my Pooh Bear. And they're going, oh, and the Mr. Sanders. You can't forget that. If anyone knows the story behind the sign Mr. Sanders, leave it in the comments below. I already know the answer. Come on. I'm like a Disney fan. I'm a Disney fan. I wanted to add something a little bit more, so I borrowed some honeybee stamps, bees, and I drew some tails, flying trails behind them. I hope you enjoy my video. Follow us, follow me, follow Heffy Doodle on social media. We love to interact with you there, and I will see you in the next video.
You're on our way. I'm